Okay, so here we are at the front of C&K Meats in Suffolk, and this is a notorious gas chamber slaughterhouse in Suffolk, and they kill up to 4,000 pigs here a day.
Is this a bit conflicting for you? Yeah, I guess it must be hard though, like, because sometimes
we're not here. You know, this is your rights to do this.
Sent to their death. Obviously, police would be the first people here, and you know, upholding justice. And then when it comes to other species, just like most people, we just turn a blind eye, or we just let it go, or we even let the ones that pay for the injustice. So it's just like, it would be especially conflicting though, I would think, being someone in an authority position whose job is to uphold justice, and then to, like, just, you know, I've been at a vigil similar to this where the police actually escorted the trucks into the slaughterhouse so that we couldn't get this footage.
Yeah.
Okay. And I just thought, whoa, I mean.
Hard position to be in.
Yeah, it would be really hard.
Yeah, conflicting.
Yeah.
I suppose that probably happens a little bit every now and then.
It's sad.
It's just like everyday business for us, unfortunately.
We have to be impartial. We do what we're told. And
be emotionally detached in a way, otherwise if you get too involved, you can't do your job.
But surely, like, wouldn't, I mean, because sometimes laws are unjust, and there have been many experiences in the past of similar situations where law officers are put in a position where they don't feel comfortable, and they would probably disobey the ruling, they would disobey the order, surely. So I guess, like, my hope, and probably I think, is that as awareness rises about the injustice of what we do to these innocent beings, we'll probably see more and more people who are in a similar situation who start disobeying the order to protect the abusers by, you know.
Do you think one day we'll look back on this with our heads in shame that we ever did this to them, or?
I really don't know.
In the future we'll look for back.
Who knows what the future holds?
Yeah.
Because we used to look at humans like animals, some humans, you know.
Yeah.
And treat them like animals. And
how do they get killed here? Do you know?
Gas chamber.
Is it a gas chamber?
Yeah. I think it's a gas chamber.
Yeah, so it's like a
CO2 stunning.
They're stunned first, and then they put in the gas chamber.
They're stunned. It's CO2 stunning.
I actually thought they were killed from that.
No. They stun them. They render them unconscious, and then they stab them in the neck.
Okay. I actually didn't know that.
Yeah. Good to know. The gas chamber is horrible. Have you seen the footage of the gas chambers?
No.
They squeal and pat because it's called carbonic acid. It reacts with the moisture inside their body when the CO2 reacts with that, and it burns them from the inside out. So they get lowered down in this cage, in this dark sort of basement thing. And they're thrashing and screaming. And everyone thought that the gas was like a slow sleep.
It's supposed to be
the most humane method, but recently there's been footage released and it's horrific. Yeah.
Well, thanks for coming.
Thanks.
No worries, have a good day.
Thanks. It's okay, sweetheart. There's only two of them in here.
So name, age, whereabouts you from?
Okay, so my internet name's Joey Carbstrong. I'm a YouTuber, animal rights activist, sober lifestyle promoter. Mm-hmm. So I come from quite a colourful past.
Yeah.
I got mixed up with the wrong people and I had an awakening, and now I spend my time trying to help the most innocent victims of the planet, the animals. So.
Excellent. So when was the moment you sort of realised you wanted to become involved with this?
Someone said something to me. I was looking for a weight loss diet and I come across a raw foodist, and he said something. He said, if you eat suffering and death, it becomes you. Like, it manifests as fear and suffering and disease in your body.
Yeah.
And that stuck with me. And about 6 months later, I just made the switch.
So what do you think of, like, events like this? How does it progress?
I think they're very important.
Yeah.
People need to see the victims that before they go in. It's the biggest enemy of injustice is the truth, is showing people what's happening. So people need to see the eyes of their victims, that they're individuals, they suffer, they're in pain, and it's a way to snap people out of it. People don't look at the bacon, which is a euphemism, it's a dead pig. They don't look at that bacon and think that it was an animal that once had a individual personality and wanted to live and then suffered and screamed in pain in a gas chamber. So.
Oh, excellent. Well, thanks for talking to me. That's fantastic. Thanks.
Sorry it was a bit doom and gloom, but we're out the front of a slaughterhouse.
Can I get a picture of you?
Of course you can. So they don't just kill the young ones, the 5-6 months old pigs. They also kill the sow mothers. So when they're spent, when they're done doing what the farmer wants them to do, the mothers are taken here and they're killed. Some of them still have milk from their teat dripping out. So these are mothers, enslaved mothers, that they're putting into the gas chamber with children as well. Okay, so just behind me is where the gas chambers are, where they're killing the pigs. So we just stopped here to get some audio so you can hear what they go through.
Scream.
A beautiful puppy. So that man there he's got a pet greyhound in the front of his car, yet he's driving a bunch of other animals to slaughter. So the disconnect is real. So whereabouts do you work?
I work at the Dis Express.
Is it a newspaper?
That's a local newspaper in Norwich.
So what do you think about veganism and the ideology of veganism?
Well, I've tried to be a vegetarian before. It didn't quite work out.
Okay.
Mainly because of the environment that I'm surrounded in.
Yeah.
But I think it's very... I can see the ethics behind it. I think it's a very commendable thing to do. I think it takes a lot of willpower to do.
Wow.
I think it's a very...
Do you think seeing pigs getting driven into a gas chamber sort of galvanizes that sort of vegan ideology in you? Like, do you think it...
How could it not? It's such a horrific thing.
Wow.
I guess when you're in a supermarket and you pick up a packet of bacon, you don't really think of that at the time. But even just walking down the road and you see like a big truck of, pigs being taken to slaughter, it really triggers it in your mind.
What have they done to you? Look at the side of her. We live in a world where we have the freedom of choice.
Mm-hmm.
So in the UK there's many vegan options. Do you think we have a moral obligation to choose a vegan option over one that contains the body of an animal that suffered and went through great pain? Do you think we have an obligation to choose something else?
I think the sort of tables are turning. I think it's heading towards that direction. Yeah. I think it might be a long way off yet before there's a sort of something in the back of your mind where you think this is entirely wrong.
Wow.
I think it's moving towards that direction.
Okay, I'll leave you with this one. If you were the victim, would you want someone to choose something else?
Oh, of course I would. Obvious answer, isn't it?
Thanks for your time, mate.